In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to make a shirt in Roblox. Before this tutorial gets started, please be sure to hit that like button and that subscribe button, and let's jump straight into the video. So you want to go ahead and log into your Roblox account, and then go up to the top here where it says create and click on that. If it's your first time clicking this tab, you're going to get this screen that pops up. What you want to press is manage my experiences. It's going to load up this page, and this is the developer page or the creator page, and you want to go over to avatar items, click on that. Okay, so after clicking on avatar items, go ahead and select shirts or t-shirts. It's basically the same thing, and then click upload asset. And now, since we need the template to begin this tutorial, we need to click learn more, and now we can go ahead and save our shirt template. So right click on the left image, because this is the shirts template. On the right is the pants template. So click save as. You can also do this on your phone by just holding down the image and then clicking save, and that will give you the template as well. Okay, now that we've got the template, we can go ahead and open a photo editor. You can use Photoshop, but I'm assuming people don't have money to spend on Photoshop. So you can use Pixlr, which is actually my favorite photo editor. It gives the most tools to work with, and it is online. You don't need to download anything. It's free, you don't need an account. But if you don't want to use that, just search up online free photo editor and you'll have a bunch to choose from. All of these are good, but in my opinion, Pixlr is the best. So you just want to go ahead and open image and open up the template. Okay, so once you've got the editor open, the first thing you want to do is make a new layer. So come over to the layers tab here and find the plus sign, and then you want to click empty. So now we've got an empty layer that we're drawing in. So now you want to click this little dotted square over here, which is the select tool, and you want to select the part that you want to edit. I want to edit the torso, so I'm going to do that first. And once you've got it selected, what you want to do now is come over to the fill tool, which is this little paint bucket. And before you fill the space, what you want to do is select the color down here, and I'm going to select this color. It's like the color for my logo. So you select the color that you want to use and then press OK. And now when we click in the box, it's going to fill that selected area with the color we just selected. So to deselect it, just press Ctrl D and it's going to deselect the part that you just selected. Now we can go ahead and finish up the torso. But before that, we need to select the up and the down part like so. And we can go ahead and fill that in again by clicking the fill tool, or we can go ahead and draw that in like this, and you can draw little patterns and stuff, but it is just easier to fill it. So if you run into any mistakes, you just want to go edit and then undo, or press Ctrl Z, and now we can fill that up. So I'm just going to keep that one color, but you can choose to have the front and the back different shades if you want. Remember, press Ctrl D to deselect. So one color is good for me. And if you select the little mouse tool up here, you can actually go ahead and resize the image or move it. So just make sure it covers the whole template. I recommend making a separate layer for the right arm and the left arm as well, just so you don't have to delete anything in the torso. And I'm going to do the same thing for the arms. I'm going to select it and then I'm going to fill it. But this time I'm going to change the color by clicking the little circle and then selecting the color that I want to change it to. So there we go. And then I'm going to fill. Control D to deselect. Press the marquee select tool, which is a little square, the dotted square, and select the upper and down bit. And then we're going to fill it again. Press the paint bucket. Click. And that is filled. And I'm going to go ahead and do the same real quick for the left arm. And there we go. So you can rename the layers as well by right clicking on the layer and just giving it a name. So if you forget which part of the template is which, you can go ahead and drag the background image to the top. And that's going to show you where you are designing things. So I need to design things in the front, which is here. I'm going to put my logo on the front and the back. So I'm going to go ahead and draw a G, but I'm going to make sure the brush is a bit smaller. There we go. And I'm going to draw a G. So you can do something like this, or you can add like a little picture or something like that. I'm going to actually add my logo. So go over here, select add a image. I'm going to add my logo. So you're going to need to resize it. This can be any image, by the way. There we go. So now my logo will be on the front. The design looks pretty plain right now. So what most people do is they go onto their browser and they search up Roblox overlay template. Make sure it's 585 by 559, which is the size of the template. Then you go to images and you want to select one that looks exactly like the template. So the template looks like this. So make sure it has a transparent background. Make sure you save it as a PNG. And then when you go back to the Pixlr editor, click on add and then add an image. Find the image you just downloaded, click open. So if it's transparent, you shouldn't get the checkered things that show up. Resize the shading if you need to. It can overlap, it doesn't matter too much. You can change the visibility by clicking on the layer and adjusting the opacity. So I'm going to adjust it to about 70%. And there we go, that looks better. So now that the design is done, we're just going to go ahead and save the template by clicking File, Save, make sure quality is 100%. Save it as a PNG, make sure it's 585 by 559, click Save As, save it anywhere, make sure you give it a name, and then press Enter. Now that the image is saved, we can go back to the Roblox Creator menu, go to Upload Asset, click Upload, find the shirt that we just saved, click Open, and it will give it a name and a description, so go ahead and upload it. And it's going to upload the t-shirt. T-shirts are free to upload, but if you want to upload a shirt, it costs 10 Robux. But you can also sell it as well on the marketplace. And to upload and sell your shirts on the store, I'm pretty sure that you need to get premium, which is $30 a month. And you also get 2,200 Robux. So if this video did help, please hit that like button. And if you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button as well. Leave in the comments down below if you had any troubles with this video. I'll do my best to help you out. That is it from me. Peace out.